legacy that I was able to leave behind at Brock in football was just the standard to play at, how good the team should be, I guess. I guess we weren't really expected to do as good as we did my last season, and we kind of set an example for years to come, how hard we need to play. Heaven's gotta be this kind of town. In this kind of town, we know how to fix it. We know how to make it, we know how to mix it. Friday night lasts all weekend long. We crank it up loud and sing a little song about this kind of town. We work hard, play hard.
My name is Tyler Gray. I'm a sophomore here at Brock. I'm a defensive back and running back. This year was my first year as a high school player to play in the playoffs, and it was a different experience filled with a lot of emotion and a lot of excitement. Sunday morning rolls around, we walk up the aisle and kneel down. We look around at all we've been given.
Victor Allen was probably one of the best parts coming out after the or before the game, because you know the hype, the fan support that we had, all the little kids, and just to be able to come out and show them what it's really like to be a varsity football player.
The old man ramble at the brand new McDonald's. Talk about the war and the football team, saying, Lordy me, I never thought I'd live to see this kind of town. We work hard, play hard, take our paycheck straight to the Walmart. Girls will out drink you, boys will out hank you. Tie yellow ribbon on a tree to say thank you.
My name is Tyler Stoughton. I'm number 7. I play defensive back. I tore my ACL at the beginning of the season. I sat out the whole year, but it was a truly different experience getting to sit on the sideline and watch my team succeed. You really learn to look at things in a whole new perspective, and it was a great ride.
Senior, I'm the kicker. It was an awesome experience to get to kick this year, and I look forward to taking my kicking career to the next level. If anybody needs help, let me know. I'm always here.
In this kind of town, people stay together. Nobody leaves unless they leave forever. But then again, they don't really leave, 'cause deep down inside of me.
Well, I think it was a great thing for the younger kids, for us to get out there and really talk to them, and be able to carry on the tradition from the older guys to the younger guys. I think it really means a lot to them to see us supporting them just as they support us.
We know how to make it, we know how to mix it. Friday night lasts all weekend long. We crank it up loud and sing a little song about this kind of town. We work hard, play hard, take our paycheck straight to the Walmart. Girls will out drink you, boys will out hank you.
The game that stands out the most to me throughout the season was the district championship against Boyd. To go undefeated in district our first year at UIL and be the district champs was an amazing feeling. And it was even better to win it against our rival, Boyd, and to show everyone who thought that we weren't going to be able to even make the playoffs that we were more than any other team in our district.
This kind of town, there's peanuts in a bottle. The old man ramble at the brand new McDonald's. Talk about the war and the football team, saying, Lordy me.
One of the many highlights of our season this year was the mentorship program. My mentor Jeff Lockfoot would leave notes in my locker every Friday specific to that night's game. I really appreciate all the hard work and effort he put into writing a note specifically for me. It meant a lot, and I really appreciated it. Sunday morning rolls around. We walk up the aisle and kneel down. We look around at all we've been given, and we thank God to be living in this kind of town.
The send-offs before our games were a huge part of our playoff run. Having people line the road and having escorts just really showed how much support we have from our community. And I would like to thank everyone for taking time out of their day to do that.
Cause deep down inside of me, I know heaven's gotta be this kind of town. Stay together. Nobody leaves unless they leave forever. But then again, they don't really leave, cause deep down inside of me, I know heaven's gotta be this kind of town. In this kind of town, we know how to fix it. We know how to make it. We know how to mix it.
And stuff. It was just real focused and a lot of support from our coaches and the community. And then once it was Friday Night Lights, just whole stands were packed. Everyone was cheering. It was loud. Just playoff times are great. Can't wait for next year.
Well, our coach takes through about 2 hours of fundamentals every day.
Weight room.
Proper technique. That's all that matters.
Technique.
All right? You use proper technique and you have the right mindset, you can beat a guy three times your size. I mean, some of those hogs about 160, and we took on guys that were about 420 and put them on their backs.
That's right.
Proper technique, that's all I can say.
Weight room.
Weight room!
We walk up the aisle and kneel down. We look around at all we've been given, and we thank God to be living.
Hey everybody, Lack here. I know you think it's a little early, it's not football season yet, but I think it's time to get this fired up! Opening game's not till August 14th against the Tola Rattlers, but we will rattle their cage at night. But tonight we've got something more important on hand. We've got our fourth annual four-wheeler dance. It raises money for the Brock ISD football and sponsored by the Brock Booster Club. You're going to have a great steak dinner tonight. We've got awesome entertainment by the great Brandon Ryder. We've got great silent auction items. And we've got really good live auction items. And that's when we are going to get fired up for the live auction. Yes, sir. Bid high, bid early, bid often. You cannot win anything unless you are the last bidder. So get ready. We're going to have some fun. Get fired up, riled up. Get them football guys some money.